On December 1979, the Soviet Union began an invasion of Afghanistan, its Central Asian neighbor to the south. First, it airdropped elite troops into principal Afghan cities. Soon after, it deployed motorized divisions across the border. Within days, the KGB, which had infiltrated the Afghan presidential palace, poisoned the president and his ministers, helping launch a Moscow-backed coup to install a new puppet leader, Babrak Karmal. The invasion triggered a brutal 9-year-long Afghan civil war. It saw extensive fighting between the Soviet Union and the Afghan Mujahideen, alongside smaller groups of anti-Soviet Maoists. Most combat operations against the Mujahideen took place in the Afghan countryside, as the country's urbanized areas were entirely under Soviet control. The foundations of the conflict were laid by the Sour Revolution in 1978, which saw the nationwide seizure of power by the People's Democratic Party of Afghanistan. After executing then-president Mohammad Daoud Khan and purging his supporters, the Democratic Party initiated a series of radical land reforms and modernization efforts throughout Afghanistan. By April 1979, large parts of Afghanistan had erupted in open rebellion. Despite Afghanistan's nominally communist leadership, Soviet leaders still couldn't relax. The new Democratic Party regime, divided and unstable, faced fierce cultural resistance from conservative and religious leaders. By the time the last Soviet troops pulled out in early 1989, rumbling back across the ironically named Friendship Bridge. The conflict had cost the lives of an estimated 1 million civilians and some 125,000 Afghan, Soviet and other combatants. The war wreaked havoc not only on Afghanistan, but on the Soviet Union, whose economy and national prestige took a severe drubbing. In the fall of 1979, revolutionary Hafizullah Amin orchestrated an internal Democratic Party coup that killed the party's first leader and ushered in his brief but brutal reign. National unrest soared and Moscow's hand-wringing intensified. Afghanistan's chaos alarmed Soviet leadership primarily because it increased the odds that Afghan's leaders might turn to the United States for help. Top Politburo members warned Brezhnev in late October 1979 that Amin sought to pursue a more balanced policy and that the United States was detecting the possibility of a change in the political line of Afghanistan. Only weeks later, KGB head Yuri Andropov joined the Soviet Union Foreign Minister Andrei Gromyko and its Defense Minister Dmitry Ustinov in sounding the alarm. They persuaded Brezhnev that even if the Americans weren't actively trying to undermine Soviet influence in Afghanistan, Amin's ruthless but unstable regime would create weaknesses the US could later exploit. Moscow, they argued, would have to act. Soviet troops occupied Afghanistan's cities and all main arteries of communication, whereas the Mujahideen waged guerrilla warfare in small groups across the 80% of the country that was not subject to uncontested Soviet control, almost exclusively comprising the rugged mountainous terrain of the countryside. By mid-1987, Soviet leader Mikhail Gorbachev announced that the Soviet military would begin a complete withdrawal from Afghanistan. The military misadventure would contribute significantly to the Soviet Union's later collapse and breakup in 1991. The war contributed to the fall of the Soviet Union by undermining the image of the Red Army as invincible, undermining Soviet legitimacy, and by creating new forms of political participation.